Mother Earth, Svalin, Mundilfari, Mandala. Earth, mother of Thor, but his father is Odin, consciousness. Mother Earth has a shield named Svalin the Cooler. If it falls off, I know that land and seas will burn up. So warn us our heathen holy myths and poems. This we should know, men, and preserve the atmospheres like the ocean layer. Or perhaps Goddess Sun has the shield so that her golden-maned chart horse does not get too hot. It was a laughing matter for many that heathens claim Mother Earth to be a living being. Such stupidity to claim mountains and stones and waters and sand to be living indicated the absurdity of heathenry. We had more ice and less electric lights at that time, but she is and has always been a beauty, and she is all life. Sometimes I'm not sure if we earthlings deserve her, our caring mother. Life seems to pop up wherever it can. For us, the whole cosmos is some kind of a living phenomenon. We love our Mother Earth, we love our Mother Nature. Even in the first part of Hávamál, the Karmakanda part, meant for the crudest of men, we are asked to take no more than sparingly needed of nature's gift. So fundamental is this responsible behavior of men. There are many stories about floods. The sins of men end in a flood. Be it the southern god's wrath, or be it man's stupidity to forget to do his TM, forget to give back to nature for what she gives us. Take and take heedlessly until the tolerance of Mother Nature can no more take it. She has tolerance to a certain limit. She can shake us off, naughty, stupid creatures, as if we were dust mites on a carpet that a housewife vigorously dusts off her balcony. That is how mothers react when her little worms are intolerably stupid. There are limits to motherly tolerance. It turns out to be our responsibility not to sink to the bottom of the sea along with our land.